All right.
Welcome to seminary. Mark your reading, answer the general question, who or what is the greatest threat to my happiness? And be a decent person today. For our we have I'm doing conducting and I messed up. Jake, you're doing what must be done. Music and personal shares by Tessa, and Addie Renault is going to give our opening prayer. Personal share is Tessa, and then Asher, you're giving a closing prayer.
That's good to know.
You've been voluntold. Announcements? The board is empty for today again. Nothing going on? Okay. Yeah?
I don't know how many of you are interested, but today, if you are interested in playing lacrosse, there's a meeting in Mr. Watkins' room after school.
All right, let's write it down. Lacrosse meeting.
That's for anyone.
What's the abbreviation for lacrosse?
LAX.
LAX. Lacrosse meeting. Yeah. What time?
Yeah. After school.
2:45. School out at 2:40.
I don't know when it's gonna end. But it's...
For something you don't enjoy so much, you don't end, and you don't know when it ends when it's over. 2:40. And whose room?
Mr. Watson's room.
Watson.
Yep.
All right. Thanks for that. No announcements. Okay, Tessa. You share.
Hey Holly.
Yeah.
Could you play a song?
Oh, I'd love to.
Could you play I Stand All Amazed?
Yeah.
Why and what?
This is my favorite hymn.
Your favorite hymn?
Yeah.
There are a lot to choose from. This being your favorite, that's significant. Mm-hmm. And what are we doing? Are we singing this song?
You can sing, or you don't have to sing. You can if you want to.
If we make it optional,
yeah.
I would be surprised if anybody sings, because he might be singing like a solo or a duet. It's 193, right?
Yeah.
Somebody want to sing? All right, those who want to sing, we'll sing.
Please help us.
us to be able to fill the Spirit and to keep our hearts and minds open during the lesson. Please help us to have a good day and to stay safe, and it is in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Thanks, Holly. Thanks, Tessa. Personal trip.
I don't really have one today. I forgot that I was doing this. But I guess, like, animals.
I guess, like, animals?
I guess, like, I love my cat so very much, and it reminds me, like looking at him, like, him being around me, it reminds me that, animals are made to be companions to people, and I'm very thankful for them.
Huh. What does having, having your beloved cat do for you? How does it help you or bless you? What do you love about it? Who else is close to their pet or has been close to an animal? Like, perhaps more than a human being, right? Like, what? So, open it up to everybody else. Why do you love your pet? Is that a good question? Start with you.
I love my pet because he's very sweet. He knows when I'm upset, and he listens to me.
Oh yeah, in fact, cats are—they're like emotional little animals, aren't they? So it comforts you to have. So you feel like that your cat is in tune enough with your emotion that the cat can actually come to you when you're upset. And what does a cat do to comfort? Licks your fingers?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's like proactive. I was expecting to hear the cat comes close to me so that I can pet it.
No, he doesn't like being pet.
Oh, really?
No.
Oh, okay. What else is it? What is it else is like magical about pets that seems to be helpful for some humans? Raise their hand. Seth, what do you like about your pet? James?
Oh, my dog, Bear. He's very special. He's not the brightest at all, but he's really cute, and he just has like this like wholesome aroma, I guess. Like
aroma? The dog smell?
No, it's like
it's wholesome.
Like an aura. I don't know.
Oh,
don't
aura.
Know. Aura. Sorry.
Yeah, like an energy.
It's like, yeah. It's like, yeah. Okay. Whenever I'm around my dog, he just like makes me happy.
Yeah.
Because
he's
like,
happy, right?
He's like a smile on his face. It's like he's this goofy little smile that it does. It always gets me, no matter what mood I'm in.
Can anything get Bear down?
No.
It's like the dog's happy. James?
I was just going to say that pets give us an opportunity to learn how to be responsible. That's why my parents got a lot of pets.
Do you have a business relationship with your pet?
I take care of you. You give me a chance to be responsible. It's symbiotic. But also, aside from that, just transactional, like you're learning how to take care of those things. But that's huge. That's actually really, really important. Be able to take a sense of responsibility for something. Okay, good. Anybody else? I feel like I've learned a lot from our family dog Zeppelin. I wouldn't consider myself like a big animal lover, but lately I've really been trying to just learn what are animals, kind of. That's kind of a weird thing to be thinking about, but like, God created everything, right? And some animals they don't want to be your pet. They want to eat you. But some animals are good at being companions, and it can actually save people's lives, literally to have something to love and something that loves them back. Because sometimes human beings can be incredibly difficult to love and be loved by. And pets provide an amazing opportunity to experience that comfort, something to love, something to be loved by, and be responsible for. Okay, thanks, Tessa. Hope your cat. How old is your cat?
He's going to be 3.
3, not too old. Yeah, you take pretty good care of that cat, don't you? All right. Anything else? I see you all have your yellow sheets, most of you out. You're cram studying right now, which is good. Why do you think I want you to, I'm encouraging you and rewarding you with confectionery delights for memorizing phrases from this? What is the value of it? You memorizing it doesn't do anything for me. I've already memorized it. Why do you think I want you to? What is the value of committing scripture, truth, to memory?
I think there's a few reasons. Probably because, I mean, it's good for you because these are all true things that can be comforting in hard times. But also because, as you know, we all go out in the world, especially on missions, there's a lot of people who are Christian and who know these scriptures really well. And it's a lot easier to connect with those people who are really, really familiar with biblical texts, if you also have.
Awesome. Okay, so you're thinking ahead and thinking, I can be a more useful missionary if I'm familiar with some non-restoration scripture to build on common ground. Absolutely true. Good. Thank you. Why else? Has anybody else chosen on their own, volunteered themselves to memorize scriptures or quotes that speak truth? By raise of hands, who has chosen to, wanted to memorize good stuff, to have it in your head for recall at any moment?
Like not for
4.5, huh?
Like not for reward?
Well, you would do it for your own reason, which means you have a sense of some reward for it, but it's not an external reward. Nobody asked you to, nobody made you, huh?
So not like a cake for memorizing all the articles of faith.
Unless you buy yourself the cake, or you bake it and then you eat it. No, yeah, never mind. No, that's an external reward, extrinsic reward, which sometimes is necessary to get kids to do things. Jacob, why and what? What and what?
Was the first vision, like I saw the color of light.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's as far as you got?
No, I got.
I'm just kidding.
Well, it wasn't really me. My mom challenged me to memorize it all.
Okay.
That still counts.
She challenged you. Did she reward you?
No.
Okay. Well, there you go. So you took the challenge. Why?
I like challenges. I don't know. I thought I could do it.
Please your mom?
No. I mean,
partly.
Always you want to please your mom, but.
Okay. What benefit did you derive from having done that?
Well, if you have it in your head, you always think about it, so you gain a better understanding about it.
Mm-hmm. With repetition comes comprehension. In everything. The more you do it, the more you're going to understand it and be fluid with it. So, good. Okay, great. So, you benefited from having a better understanding of the first vision by having gone to the work of memorizing those words and phrases. Okay? Ash, you're like, sort of.
Sort of. I mean, I don't know if it counts because I've worked on memorizing the third verse of How Firm Foundation.
Okay.
I like the words in it.
You're not. I am with thee. Do you know where those words come from?
Probably
Old Testament. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think
so many times in the Old Testament, those phrases are used, including in the song, more or less. Why did you want to memorize that?
Like, well, like a message, and it kind of inspires me, I guess. So like, whenever I feel down or like, can't do something, it's fear not, I am with thee, line up this name.
Why wouldn't you be dismayed?
For I am thy God, and
what's he gonna do? Because he's your God, and he's with you.
Be that faith, God, and will still be the aid.
Right. Like, yeah. So you kind of like, I don't know, but you memorize it because there are times when you may feel dismayed, you may feel down, you may feel afraid, and so having that truth right here, ready to be the antidote to the solution to the problem, is so powerful. I can't encourage you enough to commit truth to memory, word for word. Discipline your mind enough to memorize some scripture or phrase or hymn or primary song that means something to you. The repetition will bring comprehension. The access will bring truth to your mind when you are experiencing a darkness or an untruth. Okay? You.
I sort of memorized Moroni 7:9.
Charity? No.
It's about prayers. It's, and likewise it is also counted evil unto a man if he shall pray and not with real intent of heart, for it profiteth him nothing, and God receiveth none such. So it just sort of helped me to remember to put some variation in my prayers and to actually mean it instead of just doing the same monotonous
thing that we always do. It must be kind of boring for God sometimes.
Yeah.
It's like I want to hear from him, but they just keep writing the same letter on over and over again. And Holly, you raised your hand.
Yeah, I did the same thing that Jacob did. Actors for my seminary class, we didn't get rewarded for it. Our seminary teacher, said, you guys should memorize this. So I did, and I don't anymore because it's really long.
The first edition.
Mm-hmm.
Parts of it. I mean, you can't memorize the entire thing, but
yeah.
I mean, the entire whole section. I have found that I've memorized lots of scriptures. And I'm a lot older than you, so I've had more time. And maybe more reasons, too. But truly, those words have come to my mind many, many, many times to comfort me, to teach me, to remind me. And not times when I've just chosen to recite them, but times when my life circumstance called for that message. And it was right there. You know how much time you have in a day when you're doing, like, almost nothing, but you can't be doing anything else. It's awesome to recite, you know, words of truth in your mind, commit things to memory. Have something on your phone that you can just review quickly. It's so good. So good. What did Jesus do when Satan came tempting him? How did he respond to Satan when he was fasting 40 days in the wilderness? Do you know how Jesus responded to every temptation Satan put to him?
Did he even say that?
He said that at the end. But before that, you're right. And before that, he just recited scripture. He said, "For it is written, thus saith the Lord." So his answer to Satan when he was being tempted was to quote scripture. Here's an untruth being said. Well, here's a truth. Here's darkness. I'm going to shine light. And that gave him strength to overcome the temptation. There is real power in memorizing scripture. Even if it is for an incentive, an extrinsic reward, do it anyway. You'll get the cake and you'll get the benefit too. Okay, so I want to give you a chance to do this. We're just going to start. Everybody want to give it a chance, right? So, yeah, your question.
I was going to say, can we have like 2 minutes to think about it?
2 more minutes?
And peace.
How many minutes have you had since I first invited you to do this? How many minutes? How many hundreds of thousands of minutes? Jacob. Yeah, you can take that while other people are doing it. I think we're just going to go around.
Already on that side. Because I'm already sitting alone.
Sitting alone? Like, what? What does that have to do with it? Rock, paper, scissors? Okay, Tessa and Bridget.
Yeah, I don't know the whole thing.
We have a volunteer?
Grant.
Maybe we'll take volunteers, Grant. Because you know what happens.
The earlier you go, the more selection you get. You're not gonna be getting one of those, though, right? Think about the
You got it.
Okay.
I'll go next.
Oh, now because did you volunteer first? Okay, we'll go.
Mine's quick. I got like.
I'll put this. You'll get something. Everybody will get something, right?
Okay, here you go.
Lord is my shepherd; I shall not want. He maketh me to lie in green pastures. He leadeth me by still waters. That's all, yeah. He restored my soul, I think.
Do you need to be word for word?
I don't know.
No.
Word for word, word for more.
Huh? Idea for idea.
I feel like if you miss one or two, it's
a couple nice of words. Unless it's a significant word.
Yeah.
Okay, that was four.
He restored my soul, right?
That's what I'm finding.
Is that what comes next?
The last one?
Yeah. Five.
Yeah.
Take five candies.
It's like top four.
Yeah.
Okay, Jacob. Jesse, you're after that.
One more three, please.
Go.
All right. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pasture. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, and thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of thy enemy. One second. Presence of my enemy. He anointed oil upon my head. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me in the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Right on.
That was good.
Nice.
I was about to fumble.
Yo, you did awesome. That was like, it was, it's kind of emotional for me to hear you recite, even though these are just, we're doing this, they're powerful words. Wow. Okay. Come on, enjoy. What does that mean?
I mean,
now he's gloating?
It means luck for a good luck.
Yeah. Y'all volunteering now?
I was.
Well, it was Tessa, and then Ivy, and then Holly.
Oh,
wait, did you get your candies?
Yeah,
I'll go after Holly.
Ones?
No. Okay, Tessa.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall not fear, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all of my days, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I don't think that was...
You missed one verse.
I missed one verse.
Start at the beginning again.
Okay.
The Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I'm sorry. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. Can I get a hint?
We'll come back to you.
I'm sorry.
We'll come back to you. Because I want you to get it. And if you listen for a minute, you'll be reminded. Okay?
You missed one phrase.
That's not my one.
Okay.
We're going to come back to you and you'll get all of the stuff.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He leads me beside, He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He makes me walk in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk in the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me.
thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me for like all my days. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Yeah. Good job. That's it. Come and get your donut. Where's that? Ready yet, Tessa? Okay, you keep working on it. Okay.
Can I go after Holly?
Can I go? Hey, I recorded
after Holly.
Hold on. Oh, you've been waiting for a while, right?
Yeah.
Okay, we're just like getting everybody.
Okay, Brett.
Okay.
Holly
and then Brown. Yeah. Okay.
I
need
to
try
this one again.
Yeah.
Well, as many as you need.
Oh, okay.
But not in a row because we're gonna give other people.
Okay.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still water. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Come on! Yes.
It's written in glasses.
Yes. It's so interesting how everybody's got their like little system. Jacob Barr's like,
he's praying.
And Tessa's like looking at the wall. Ivy's looking at the ceiling. Everybody's got their own way of concentrating.
I do it.
Okay. Huh? Can I look right at this yellow paper? That's my method. Oh, yeah. The back of the line. You want more time to work on it. Less selection, but more opportunity than more. Okay, Holly.
Okay. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me, and shall be with me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Yes. Yes.
I know, I was like, what is it?
Nice work. Hey, go get yourself a donut.
Oh no.
Bridget.
That's not going to be as good as Holly. Okay. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, because he is with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. No, I know this. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Wait, no, is it the oil? No. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. No, I knew it too. And it's some line and it's He anointeth my head with oil. My cup runneth over.
There's one before that.
No. I don't know it.
You do. You just forgot it.
You got it.
It's still in there.
No, wait. What did I just say before that, though?
That
rod and thy staff, they comfort. No, I know this, too.
Okay, we'll come back to you.
How? What is it?
Okay, but that's awesome. The table one. Okay, who's next? Okay, Jason Addy.
Dang it.
All right. Okay, no helping people. I know you love each other.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
Two!
He maketh me to lie down in green pastures.
He does!
Three.
I'll stop this second.
Yeah, I'll cash out and take my.
Maybe so.
Woo! All of it lies.
Yeah. Making me the light on the crack green pastures, he leadeth me.
Thou anointest my head.
So
dang, I
did
this one.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay,
at least four. Like,
the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me on the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy will be with me in all my days, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Yes! Yes.
Can you get your donut, and then take some candy? You guys to go next? And then ask you. Okay? Oh, you've been here forever. Wait, you said you wanted to go last.
No, I just meant like when I could go.
Oh, yeah, we'll get to you.
Okay, that's fine.
We'll get to everybody. Okay.
Right.
J. Michael.
I gotta get four.
Four. Like, barely looks at it and shuts it. Okay, that's good. I didn't say you couldn't.
Alright. Lord, my shepherd, I shall not want. Make it me lie down in green pastures. He restores my soul.
No!
You get out of
order. If I know that
you out of order.
You can do him out of order.
Well,
he's
a full soul.
He leads me to the still waters, and then he restores my soul.
The easy one.
Can I just do one that I remember?
You get credit for what you know, but to get the one, it has to be in order.
And I'm not gonna
get the candies are for phrases.
He anointed my head with oil. And rod and staff, they comfort me. That's all.
Okay, seven. Way to go.
Wait, so I
toss a light.
Did you get how many lines are there?
I know. That's why I said you can like take a handful. I think there are 12. There are 12 on here. There are like 6 verses.
Let me spit these bars out, brother.
I know. My cup ran over.
Go ahead. You got like 7. Okay, Asher.
Hold on. Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He leads me. No, he maketh me lie down on green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear not, because he's good, or thou art with me, something like that. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. I prepared the table in presence of my enemies. I anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall be with me till the end of my days. And I will like live with God at the end, something like that. I will dwell.
Do a little better than that.
Okay.
At the very end.
I will dwell with the Lord.
Hey,
Hang on.
That's not quite it.
His face is on there.
It all comes down to
I shall dwell in the house of the Lord someday.
Careful, you might regret this forever.
No pressure.
I will
dwell in the house of the Lord. You said
for
the house
what?
Of the Lord.
For what?
For all eternity.
One more word. Yeah, there you go. For all eternity.
Simpler.
Sure.
Yeah, forever.
Forever. Okay.
Yes. Good job. Give him a hand. Yes. It was a little dicey at the end. It was a little dicey.
Well, at least I did.
Okay, you ready again? Okay, then we'll come back.
Yes.
And well, everybody else will get a chance. We're getting a long time. Here you go. Listen up.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He restoreth my soul. Sorry. Restoreth my soul. He leads me down the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk down the valley of the shadow of death, I shall not fear. Thou art with me. Thine staff and rod to comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all my days. For then I will surely be in the house of the Lord for all eternity.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Round two. There you go. Go get yourself a donut. Okay, who still wants to go? James wants to go. Bridget. Any other takers? Sure, we don't.
But James, go ahead.
We'll pick this up tomorrow morning. Okay, James, hit us with the whole thing.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Yes, he is.
I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Where's the candy? Come and get your lunch. You even got all of these owls and eyes. The X and stuff. That was great. Okay, Bridget.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the house of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me throughout all my days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Yeah!
Yes!
Did it. Awesome. Okay, we have time for maybe one. Anybody else want to go for the whole thing?
I do want
to go. Yeah, take a donut. You earned it.
I'm a different person.
Right, you're a new man. Okay. And then tomorrow, anybody else wants to try the phrases? Whoever we missed, because there are some who aren't here today even, so we're going to have another chance tomorrow. But if you tried today, I don't know. That's a little tricky. Okay, Brett, go.
It was a funny joke. You see, the joke here was that I already went, but I took off my glasses, so I looked like a different person.
Oh, I get it. So somehow you would be able to memorize it better.
No,
so he could get another donut.
Oh. That was over my head. Okay, you guys are awesome. Thank you for the effort. What? Yeah, way over my head. Okay, tomorrow you'll get a chance if you didn't get a chance today. You didn't run out of time. Leave this with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Do I save the donuts till tomorrow? We'll put them in airtight plastic so they don't
age too much. Really proud of the group that we're able to gather here today and learn about Psalm 23. Please help us to be able to apply what we've learned from it in our lives and help us to study it and to help teach other people in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. So proud of you guys for your effort. Way to go.